Here's the back of the operator panel that the CRT cable is going to connect into. Let me show you where that plugs in on the side down here. The machine video cable connects right here on this connector right here, and it comes up to this top connector. Now, the bottom connector is not used. This one's not used in the machine, only this one right here. So we are going to make a cable that will plug directly into this connector. Based upon the data we gathered yesterday, let's take a look and see what this connector looks like. Is it male or female? Got pins. Here's pin one. This is 9-pin DB9 connector. There's pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Looks like pin 2 has no pin. 6 and 7 have no pin. Now, the colors of the wires on the back determine their function. Here's pin 1 is black. That'll be our ground. Pin 3 is red. 4 is green. 5 is blue. That's our RGB, red, green, blue. And if we flip it over, here's white and yellow on 8 and 9. That'll be our horizontal sync and vertical sync. So let's make our cable. And we're going to plug our cable right in here to this connector right here. I'll leave that undone in case we got to look at it again. Good morning, everybody. Another day. Here's what we worked out yesterday. We had vertical sync. It's that orange connector on the Allen Bradley control. We had vertical sync on pin 1. We had the horizontal sync on pin 3. And we had video on 4, 6, and 8. I'm not sure who red and blue are. Green's always in the middle, but I could have these reversed. If the colors don't turn out right when we fire this thing up, we'll swap those two wires right there. Pin 10 is that composite video, and I'm not going to use that. We're going to go with these 5 and ground on pin 2. Let me show you that composite video circuit again. We have two signals being driven into the base of this NPN transistor, and its output goes to that orange connector on pin 10. I'm not going to use that. We're going to let that be. We're going to use these signals right here. So today, based upon this information right here, I had to go over to the operator panel and work that side out. Let me show you what I got there. The CRT circuit inside the operator panel. I don't have it all worked out, but you can see here's the DB9 connector on the back of the operator panel where the video signals go in. They have connections to all 9 pins, but you can see here there's no resistor from pin 2 to pin 3 of the connector to the SN74LS541. And here on pin 6 and pin 7, there's no resistor between here and there. Now, if you remember, just shortly, we looked at that connector. Pin 2, there's no pin on pin 2, 6, or 7. Those are left empty. Now, the red, green, blue is going to come in on that connector on 3, 4, and 5. And then the horizontal and vertical sinks will come in on 8 and 9. I'm not really sure who is vertical here and who is horizontal. It won't hurt nothing if we get them mixed up. The display just won't come up right, and we'll flip-flop those wires right there to get the signal correct. And the red, green, blue, if the colors don't come up right, we'll swap those wires around until we get good video. So let's jump into making that cable. Here's the pinouts based upon those two schematics we just looked at. I've got a green connector here. That's this one. Over here, I'm going to have a DB9 male that will mate to the back of the panel's female connector back there. Here's ground on pin 1. It's going to go to pin 2, ground here. Here's red, green, and blue on 3, 4, and 5. They're going to go to 4, 6, and 8. And here's either vertical or horizontal, not sure which. And down here is either horizontal or vertical sink, not sure which. We'll swap those around if we need to. Here's the other side, DB9M. That's going to be this connector right here. We'll have cabling in between. Let's go make that thing. Come on. We're losing daylight. Here's our cable. It's not a long one. Doesn't have to be very long. Strip that jacket back. There's some side cutters right here. Sure wish I had a tool to do this for me. Easier. But I've always nibbled away at the jacket with my side cutter, so if I had a tool to do this for me, I wouldn't know how to use it. The only thing when you're using your side cutter, you just want to make sure you don't cut that wire that you're working on. Back. Split these wires out. Right now is the point where we're going to determine which wires we want to use based upon their colors. I try to match up the video colors here. So here's a red wire, a green wire, and a blue wire. We're going to use those. Let's write that in there. Red, green, blue. We're going to use those. Here's black wire, that'll be our ground. Here's a white wire. I don't have a yellow, but we have an orange, so let's use that. Label that one white. This one orange. Okay, we're gonna cut the rest of them away so they don't confuse us. We don't need them. Cut the other ones, Deepaw. Yeah, I'll try not to. Now, Let's go to the other side, do the same thing. Fire up my soldering iron over there while we're doing this. Your fingers. don't pinch your fingers with those side cutters. Shoot, I've done that before, and I've also slipped out and poked myself. Ain't no fun either. That's why we got band-aids here in the shop. Let's see, is that the same length? First aid kit around. Don't want to leave that at the house. Just cut the rest of this away. Strain relief away. Take the foil off. There we go. Orange, black, white. On the hard part first, soldering the wires to the DV9 connector based upon our drawing here. So I always like to get my adjustable pliers to hold the connector sturdy for me so it's not sliding all over the place. Heat it up. Water right there. Wire strippers out. Just prepare that wire first. Okay. Pin 1. Now if you look inside these, you'll see pin numbers, and sometimes they have them on the back. But the way I always remember it, on the male connector, the one with pins, pin 1 is always top left, this pin right here, and it reads across, it comes down to bottom left, and moves on out. So it'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's the easiest way to remember. Looking into the male side, it is top left. Pin 1. So here's pin 1. And I always like to, when I'm working from the back side, just put a little dot over here where pin 1 is with using a Sharpie. That way you have a visual indication of where pin 1 is. You don't need to be confusing yourself and getting these wires soldered onto the wrong pins. But it just makes more work. Need even up these pins here so they don't get all bowed out. Pin 1 is going to be our ground, so we have to have a wire on pin 1. Flux on these pins. 1, 3, 4, 5. A pre-10 these wires. Get you a little bit closer here so you can see what's going on. Adding solder to the pins. And I'll tin the other side. I'll tin the wire after I strip it. And put the iron on there. Just lay it down in there and it'll drop right in. So there's 1, 3, 4, 5. And I need 8 and 9. Back in there. Takes care of that. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, let's flip it around this way again. Let's do number 1 first. Care of that. Now, watch the magic. Do wire number 1 first. That's the black wire. Just lay that down in there. Both sides, the pin and the wire, now have solder. So all I got to do is lay my iron down on top of there, melt the solder, and it'll fall right down into the socket. Is red. 1, 2, 3. Four is green. Is blue. Now, we'll turn everybody over and get the other side. This will be our horizontal sink and vertical sink wires right here. Show the white wire going to pin 8, 6, 7, 8. It's this one right here. And the orange wire going to pin 9. A little bit of solder on here that helps the flow. Slipped out of my adjustable wrench. Let's put you back in there. There, that's the last one. That takes care of that side. Let's go do the ring connector side. These connectors right here are real easy to use. You insert the wire in here and then screw the terminal down to tighten with these screws right here. Let me show you. Watch this when I'm turning that screw right there. See how that's closing up in there? That'll clamp down on the wire. Right there. Look how neat that is. These are very easy to use. Nice connector. Alright. Now we're going to attach this green connector to our homemade cable. We'll start here with the black wire. Now we'll go to pin 2. Black wire. Next is red. That goes to pin 4. Green wire goes to 6. Birdcage it on me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Goes to 8. Always double check by counting, because you don't want to hook up something wrong. Let's say we put one of these signal wires here, RGB or the horizontal or the vertical sync wires, and we wired them into ground. We just shorted the output right there and probably popped the IC, and we'd have to be working on something we didn't have to work on. So always double check yourself, and before you put power on this thing, double check it again. Triple check yourself. Okay, the white wire goes to 1. Nice and neat. Let's bring it through the bottom side there. There we go. Just the white wire. Okay, and the orange wire goes to 3. It's the last one. Goes to 3. 1, 2, 3. Run these down. We're not using them. Okay. There you go. There's our cable. This is green connector is going to mate to the Allen Bradley control, and the DB9 connector is going to mate to the back of the operator panel. we're done. Tomorrow, we'll hook it up and try it. I gotta go home and watch the grandkids while my daughter goes to work. Today's Sunday. It's an easy day. You ain't gotta work too hard on Sunday. We'll throw both feet at it tomorrow on a Monday. We'll see you in the morning.